Hello friends, welcome to my channel Electrical Master. This video I am going to explain about how soft starter is working, and we will see the complete working function of soft starter. Let's go to the video. This is the topic also we are going to discuss: what is soft starter, how soft starter is working, and wiring diagram of soft starter, and discuss soft starter uses in the industrial, and finally advantages of soft starter. Let's start with what is soft starter. We know industrial there are different types of starters available, like DOL, star delta starter, auto transformer, and BFT. So each starter is having different functions. So based on the function only, we have to choose the soft starter. We have to choose the starters. For example, DOL means it's a direct starter, it will be cheaper, and it is used for the limited HP applications. Like below 5 HP, we can use only DOL. And we know soft VFD starter, that is only for the speed control application. If you want to speed control purpose, you have to use VFD. Similarly, soft starter, it is also limiting the starting current. The main purpose of choosing this soft starter is your motors are having high capacity, like more than 10 HP means you want only purpose to limit the starting current and voltage. You have to choose soft starter is the better option compared to other starters, because we know VFD cost is very high compared to the soft starter. Okay, fine. Now we will see what is soft starter. Soft starter, it is an electronic device. It is used to temporarily reduce the motor load and torque during startup. So it is first temporarily reduce the motor load and torque. And it is applied gradually increasing the voltage to the motors, resulting in smooth acceleration of the motors and coupled load. It means this soft starter, while starting time, it's gradually apply the motor voltage to the motor terminal. So what will happen? The motor will start up gradually to the rated speed. So that we can observe that smooth acceleration. So motor will start up gradually because we are applying the voltage is gradually through the soft starter. And second line, soft starter used to limit the starting current of a high induction motor and also control the torque of the motor. I already told soft starter main purpose is you can use it for the high HP motors, more than 10 HP. Only the purpose you want to reduce starting current means you have to use soft starter. Cost wise, it is best starter for the reducing the starting current. And third point, when motor start and stop time, soft starter will make smooth ramp up and ramp down speed of the motor. So we are applying the gradual voltage to the motor terminal, so the motor speed also will be controlled by soft starter. So it will pick up, like gradually increase the speed while starting time. Similarly, while stopping time, it gradually decreases the speed. And soft starter will protect the motor from possible damage and also increase the lifespan of the motors. So these are the conditions for the soft starter. That's why we are using soft starter in industrials. Now we will see how these soft starters are working. Soft starter working is a very simple concept. You know, the soft starters, there are 6 number of SCR is used in this internal controllers. SCR means very simple. You can see this picture. SCR is in like normal diode. You can see here, there will be 3 terminals are there. One is anode, another one is cathode, and another one is gate terminal. Normally we are applying current to the anode terminal and it will transfer to cathode terminals. But that is a normal diode. But SCR, if you want to transfer current flow from anode to cathode, you have to apply the gate voltages here. Whenever we apply the gate voltage only, it will allow the current from one side to another side. Now you understand how the SCR is working. The same principle is applied here in the SCR. You can see here this soft starter connected with each 2 SCR in parallel connection. See here, R, Y, B. Like that, six number of ACR is connected in parallel, and each two will be connected to the each phases, R phase, Y phase and blue phases of the three phase motors, and the output of the terminal will be connected to the motor terminal. So from here, through the controller, we are applying the gate voltage to control the current flow from one side to another side. So like this the induction motor is working. So we are I already told, while starting time we are applying gradually increase the voltage to the motor terminal. How they gradually control the voltage? Through this gate terminal. Through the controller, we are increasing the gate voltage from 0 to the rated gate voltages. After time, the current flow from the anode to cathode terminal also in varying. If you are giving the low gate voltage signal, means it allows the low current to the anode terminal to cathode. Like this way, the motor gradually we are applying the voltages, and motor speed and torque also gradually increase. So we are obtaining the smooth acceleration of the motors. Like this way, the soft starter is working. Now we will see the wiring diagram of soft starter. You can see left side, this is the wiring diagram. Normal incoming MCCB or MCB were connected from that directly ROEB supply connected to the power terminal of the soft starter, and the output of the power terminal will directly feed connected to the motor terminal T1, T2 and T3. And you can see here on the right side, we will use some magnetic contactor. The purpose of this magnetic contactor is used for the bypass purpose. For example, we know this magnetic contact, this soft starter is made up of electronic devices. So electronic device normally producing high heat while functioning. So reducing that heat only, we are using this bypass contactor. I will tell how this bypass contactor is working. While starting time, we know the voltage will be gradually increase and apply to the motor terminal. And similarly, shutdown time gradually decrease, apply to the motor terminal. That function only controlled by this soft starter, starting and stopping. While once the motor attain full speed, so rated speed 1500 RPM means, so motor if it is running with the full speed, at the time this soft starter will transfer the main power connected to bypass contactor. So once the motor will pick up running with a full speed, at the time the power supply will be transferred like magnetic contactor, and it is connected to the motor terminal like this. Because of that, we can reduce the heat produced by the soft starter. So soft starter will be keep as a standby, and bypass contactor will take the load from the main power supply to the motor terminal. While we press the stop push button, at that time the soft starter will change the main power supply from magnetic contactor to the soft starter terminal, and it will allow the voltages gradually to the motor to shut down safely. That purpose only we are using this magnetic contactor. You can see here, this is the power terminal ROEB, and this is the output terminal ROEB downside, and this is the controller displays. From this controller display only we can monitor and program the function of the motors. We can hear full load current and voltages and starting time, whatever the parameters you can given from here. And you can start and stop the motor, you can control from here also, or through the PLC cable you can control connected to the other external device also to start and stop, remote start and stop function also it is allowed in this soft starters. You can see here there are 12 controls pins are available in the soft starter. First pin 1 and 2, this 1 and 2 pin used for the bypass output. I already told we are using the bypass magnetic conductor. So whenever the motor run is the full speed, at the time this bypass conductor NO become NC. So that NC conductor you can connected here to the coil supply of this magnetic conductor. This magnetic conductor for energize, we need to give the coil supply. So for example, it is needed phase and neutral. Neutral you can directly connect it to the A2 terminal of magnetic contactor, and A1 terminal will be connected to the pin number 2. So phase supply you can connect it in the pin number 1. Once the motor run at full speed, at the time this NO become NC, so that phase supply will connected to 1 to 2. The 2 will be connected to the A1 of the magnetic contactor. At this that's why the 1 and 2 terminal is used. Same like 3 and 4 terminal time delay output, it is used for the PLC devices, and 5 and 6 used for the failure output. Whenever the soft shorter detect any protection like overload, short circuit, other motor protection, then it will activate this NO become NC. So you can take in this output 6 from external alarms like motor annunciator panel, you can connect it to that external alarm like motor trip. Other than that, you can see here 7, 8, 9, 10 terminal. This 10 is the common supply we are connected, and always 7 and 10 will be NC. If it is NC only, the soft shorter will allow the power from main contactor to MCB to the motor terminal. If it is become NO, it will won't start the motors. Like immediate instantaneous trip, like short circuit, something will happen. This 7 and 10 terminal will become open. Similarly, 8 and 10 is used for the stop. See here, this stop push button, 8 and 10 will be always NC contact. When we press the stop push button, 8 become open. Similarly, 9 and 10 used for the startup condition. When we press the green button, at the time this 9 and 10 will be closed, and it will give the command to start the motors. Similarly, 11 and 12, it is giving a DC supply used for the external controlling PLC controlling device. We need instantaneous 4 to 20 milliampere, it is giving the output. These are the control terminals given in the soft starters. Now we will discuss soft starter uses in the industrial. I already told the main purpose of soft starter is limit the starting current only. And also, if the motors are having high capacity, means like more than 10 capacity, 20, 30, 40, you can use soft starter is the best solution. Cost wise also, it's the best solution for the start of the motor. See here, I consider two examples. One is for the dust collector fan. This is the dust collector fan in the industrial. Instead of soft starter, for example, we are using DOIL starter for the starting this dust collector fan. What will happen? DOIL, we know it will not reduce any starting current, directly apply the voltage to the full load voltage to the motor. So it will give the full load voltage to the motor. This is a high HP motor. So the motor will reach the inverse current and high voltages to the motor terminal. So motor will give full speed at immediately. You can see the output of the motor terminal connected with the pulley and belt to the fan terminals. So it will give full tension to the this pulley and belt. So there is two chances will happen. One is there is one chance the belt will be get damaged. Another chance it will damage that rotating fan. For avoiding this, you can use soft starter. So soft starter will give gradually increase the voltage to the motor terminal, so the output of the motor speed also will be gradually rotated, so the tension will be reduced, so cooling fan will start up with the gradual rotation. Another example you can see here, water treatment facility. Same like water treatment, we are using high HP motor coupled with the pump. It will pump the water from inlet tank to and store in the storage tank. For soft, instead of DOIL starter we are using, means it will immediately start the motor with the full speed and it will pump the water with the high pressure. So there is chance to build the tank pressure. If the tank pressure is increased, it will damage the tank. For avoiding that, we can use a soft starter to gradually increase the speed of the motor. So the flow also will be gradually increased. So we can reduce the tank pressure buildup. So these are the practical purpose we are using the soft starter. Now we will see advantages of soft starter. There are different advantages are there. Few of the advantages I mentioned. First is the energy cost reduction. So the motor will start up the with a gradually increase the voltage, so it will reduce the starting current. So power consumption also will be reduced. That's why we can easily save the energy cost. Second point, voltage and current operate gradually without the voltage and current transient. In here the voltage and current gradually we are applied, so we can easily avoid that inverse current and voltage applied by the motor. And third, it is improve the power factor at all load cycle, and thereby we can reduce in the KVA and reduce the power surges. So because we are using the controlled SCR, so we can easily control the starting current. So power surges also we can reduce and reduce the heating of the motor and improve the operating efficiency. So starting current is reduced, so we can reduce the heating of the motor, so efficiency will be increased. Then possibility of increase the number of starts per hour. Then increase the contact life of starter conductors. So using the soft starter, the life of starter conductor will be increased. Adjust the acceleration time. Here using the gate signal, we can control the voltages through 0 to rated gate voltage. So whatever the acceleration time we need the short acceleration time or long acceleration time also, we can easily adjust. So these are the advantages of soft starter. I hope now you will understand what is soft starter, how soft starter is working, and wiring diagram and industrial uses. If you like this video, give a thumbs up and share this video to your friend circle, and don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel.